was like 3 years ago, I was sent a transcript over and over again from someone in Puerto Rico. They didn't know English, and the transcript was not in English. They first began to send me this transcript every day, then it was like once a week, and I tried to correspond with them, but since they didn't know English and couldn't understand what I was saying to them, and I couldn't understand them, we couldn't correspond with each other. At the top of this transcript, it said, "The Lord told them to send me this message." But past that, I just couldn't translate it, what they were trying to say. Trust me, I tried. And then last week, I made a video of this man, Efrain Rodriguez. This was who was in the transcript. It could be who it was from. I don't know. But I listened attentively to see what he had to say. But a week or so before, a friend of mine was telling me about this little girl he saw, and he had been talking to her parents. He was telling me that this was the most beautiful girl he had ever seen, and chills ran all over me, because I knew this little girl. I'd seen her before in one of my dreams, Lincoln's in the Box. I saw her in the dream. She is one of the little girl that was dead in my dream. It was in a warehouse or a hangar. And the rows and rows of people that were dead that I was counting with a stick by fives. And I was told to wake up, saying, "Wake up, you sluggard. Oh, sleeper, wake up." At this time, I was hearing my spirit to just listen to this friend that was telling me about this little girl. And I did so. And then I was sent this video to watch, and the hair on the back of my neck stood up. And I was shown more things to come. And I want to share with you what Efrain Rodriguez had to say. There is coming an asteroid that will cause a tsunami to flood Puerto Rico and the surrounding Caribbean and the eastern coast of America. Efrain Rodriguez said he was shown that the asteroid will enter in from the sky into Puerto Rico, and this asteroid will crash in the island west of Puerto Rico. When this happens, the asteroid will enter into the ocean and smack into the seismic fault, which will then cause an earthquake of 12 points on the Richter scale. At the same time, this impact will produce a tsunami, which will enter into the island of Puerto Rico instantly. This wave will come in areas that no one would believe imaginable. Which once this asteroid has entered the atmosphere, there will be no time to hide or run. The power of the asteroid will be such that it will feel like a nuclear eruption. This asteroid is estimated to be 5 miles in diameter by NASA scientists. You cannot ask for it to stop. You cannot pray for it to be smaller by repentance or for it to be smaller in damage. By prayer, for this is the will of Yahweh. A mass wave will be moving at the speed of 400 miles an hour, according to the scientists that study these kinds of occurrences. Now, after the impact, the wave will be taking everything in its path through the Caribbean islands. It will be entering Miami, Florida around 5 a.m., according to their studies. It will make its way up to the eastern coastway of the United States, also the Gulf of Mexico and South America. Now, the experts predict that such a colossal impact would cause the Earth's rotation to cease for 3 days, meaning that the Earth will not rotate for 3 days. Now, this would in turn mean that there would be 3 days of utter darkness on this side of the earth. Now, Efrain Rodriguez says, "I dare you, in the name of our Lord, ask the Holy Spirit if this message comes from the Lord or not. As for the reports of NASA, this could happen at any time. They've tried to hide this complete message from the Lord's people, and this message is very similar to Jonah's message. Different being that they believe that the message that Jonah brought, unlike here in Puerto Rico, where the pastors kill the prophet and the message. And on that night, God will ask the pastors, 'Where are your sheep that he put into your hands?' Now the Lord told me, my servant, I will make it possible that from the big nation, the United States, they will come back to the island and will fill her again. God's church has not realized that they are entering in the beginning of birthing pains and the beginning of sorrows. And I will remind you that on that night, there will be three events coming simultaneously. The shockwave produced by the asteroid collision, a 12-point earthquake, and a giant tsunami. Not two, like the government says, according to their FEMA agencies. At this moment, the United States is preparing at a very surprising rate. They're waiting for something to impact all of the Caribbean and the Atlantic Ocean. When God told me to speak to our governor, who has a lot of knowledge on what the government agency FEMA is doing in Puerto Rico, it has with the purpose of finding a way for the population to have access to food and medication. And God has told me that this warning is not to bring panic to the churches. It is for them to prepare themselves. Now, if the population does not know what is going to take place, how will they prepare for such an unexpected event? Now, I remind you that an earthquake is not predictable. It can happen today or any time. And I will say that if we already know and understand that FEMA and NASA, the space agency, have joined together by order of the president, and at this moment, they all know that neither FEMA nor NASA have the authority to divulge any information, as this may cause worldwide panic. However, the Lord Yahweh has told his churches in Puerto Rico, no matter what denomination they belong to study and receive this message, and to prepare themselves in him. I will inform you that the word we receive from the government agencies and the information that we get from the people who work inside these agencies is that they are really concerned and worried about Puerto Rico. There are 2,500,000 bags stored in the warehouses in the docks and ports in Puerto Rico. Thousands of black boxes that can contain three corpses each have recently been sent to this island. And we know that the government has an estimated about 3 million casualties for this event, rather than the estimated 75,000 dictated by the message of the Lord to Efrain. But the Lord told us that he would never flood the earth again. But when he uses a tsunami or an earthquake to come over the land in one place, this does not violate the covenant that he made with Noah. This covenant said that he would not destroy the earth completely with water, never again. And he has not and will not break that covenant. The church has asked the Lord what to do and where and when to move. And it does not matter the percentage of the spirit you have within you. And if you pray and ask the Lord what to do, he will answer you where to move. And the security will be in him and not in a bunker. All should save up water and supplies and food. This is part of the message from the Lord. Save as much as you can, but the most important thing is to save yourself and our Lord. If you have not aligned your heart, food will remain and you will go. Get your passport as soon as possible to flee from America. Soon this window will be closed. Now, right after this tsunami, there will be an epidemic that drugs will not be able to cure. The epidemic will be deaths from the 3 days of darkness, because the corpse all over the continent will be laying out in the open. This will be on the land and in the water caused by the great epidemic. They will be airborne and in the water from diseases coming from flies and the decomposing of the bodies. Now, this epidemic will flood the borders into even Canada, as well as the judgment will include all of the East Coast, and millions will die in total. This was the end of the message from Efrain Rodriguez. Now, remember, he does not speak English, but I have included his email in the box if you want to contact him. I was shown, myself personally, Ruby, as I was watching this video. I heard in my spirit, men think that they are in control, but they're not. They've been controlling the weather, the earthquakes, the storms, and the volcanoes. But Yahweh God says, I'm in power, and I will show them that I am Yahweh. For at this time, you will see destruction on one side of the United States and at the same time on the other. For they are shooting and aiming at the moon. I am in control, not them. And then, when I had this dream, I was walking around and I could smell the most wretched smell I'd ever smelled. And now I understand, because when I had this dream, I didn't understand it all, because we all know that we're only shown things in part, which is 1 Corinthians 13 and 9. But even in the Old Testament, and I talked about this in one of my past videos, diseases came behind the floods, like typhoid, hepatitis A. But this time, the Lord was talking to me. He said, there's going to be diseases that they have never even heard of before. And this happens in judgment. There will be much destruction, as I saw in my dream. And there was dead bodies stacked on top of each other. There were cars. My mind couldn't conceive it all. There will be so much destruction. And I've warned you before, insurance companies will go broke because they won't be able to handle all the claims. Hospitals will be overflowed with the sick. There will not be room to bury the dead, nor time. Birds of the air will be feasting on the dead bodies, just as the Bible told us that they would. But they will also fall sick, as will the fish of the ocean. And the animals of the land will also die. Death will be all around us. And the water will be polluted, and the food supply will be cut short. And the government, oh, they're going to be overwhelmed. But they'll also get their wish. They will have martial law. This will be the first tsunami of three that will hit the East Coast, my friends. The last one will wipe the East Coast off the map. But as Efrain Rodriguez said, if you are not right in your heart before this tsunami, you will not be ready for it. Washington, D.C. is the Second Vatican. It will not be completely wiped off the map yet, but it will come close. Now, how loving and kind and gracious our God Yahweh is to warn us now. He loves us this much. Now, I've told you before, I live in FEMA Region 3, and I had a vision of a watery grave. Well, this is a very good explanation for this. Are you ready? Are you born again? This could come at any time. Do you know our Lord Jesus Christ? If not, call out to Him and ask our Yahweh, our Father, to forgive you in Jesus' name, and He will. Be baptized under the water, then be baptized in the Holy Spirit, and you will be born again.